Hello, everybody. This is Roger Hansen with Tuts, Tricks, Tips, Reviews, Unboxing, and I'm coming back to you with another video for working with audio and video. I believe this is part 6. You're going to have to excuse me today. I have a cold. So if I'm sniffling, making weird noises, that's because I have a cold. Today I'm going to get into video a little bit more because it's been mostly audio here lately, and I have been getting good suggestions on what to do with my video. Now I have a video set up for the things I've been doing, and after I'm done with this beginning, I'm going to go and get that all together and then continue this video from that point. But there are some things that I do want to point out. I got a suggestion to use OBS, and I went ahead and took that suggestion and used OBS instead of XSplitter. And for my first impression of it, I like it. It isn't easy to set up, but once you find good tutorials and people who know how to work with it, you can set it up pretty good. This is how I'm going to set up my preview on OBS for tips, reviews, and unboxing. It took about 4 or 5 people before I figured out what I needed to do, and the best suggestion I got out of it was to use these scenes, which I haven't been using. And the reason why they said to use it is, like, right here I have the overlay for Minecraft, I have an overlay for Command and Conquer, and then I have an overlay with for working with audio and video. And over here in my sources, I have basically this little box right here, which shows the background on the computer and everything. And then down here I have my photo for tips and tricks and all that, and like here in Minecraft I have my emblem here, and then right here is when I'm playing the game. I can capture it on there and make a quick video and be done with it and record it, And there's my avatar here, and then right here is basically the background that I can record on. Now with Command and Conquer, to make my screen bigger, if I want to record the game while I'm playing it, I have to use XSplit. The reason why is if I don't use XSplit, it'll cause the video to show up in a little cornered area right here. And in order for me to be able to do that, I have to go into XSplit and do the video on XSplit and then have it come over to OBS. And I was going to do that, but then I stopped and thought about it. I was like, all I have to do is record the video, put it in the background where I have my picture right there, and then I could use like a little avatar right here and make it smaller and be able to do it that way. And then if I wanted to talk live with audio, I could use my mic while I'm putting it on YouTube and Twitch. But that's what I figured out. I don't really have to use XSplitter in that capacity. Now, when I go to videotape the actual game I do, because the difference between Command and Conquer and Minecraft is, with Minecraft, it captures the game, and I can sit and watch the game while I'm capturing it. And with Command and Conquer, it's a full screen game, and it's a DVD that's inside of the computer, so I have to literally use the screen capture instead of the game capture, and then I have to open up the game and play the game, and I can't monitor what's going on with the capture device. So I have to play the game, then go back through and see how it all worked out. And that's really a pain in the butt. And plus, it's a CD. Well, that is my big issue with that, and that's the reason why I have to use XSplitter, because it shows this whole area right here. And if I use this one, I'll probably be able, it'll show up with maybe about that much space. That right there is how much that'll show up on the OBS. I've tried to adjust it and everything, and I haven't been able to. So, and like right here, whenever it's like that, it'll show maybe that much, and then there'll be freaking like black area around it. So I'm gonna have to use XSplit to make it bigger, to where it's this size instead of this size. I don't know, it sounds complicated, but that's basically what the deal is with me on that one. There's another thing that I do like too, and it's up here on the tools. They have an auto configuration wizard, and it's in beta right now, but I do like it, because what it does is, it actually, if you want to get the best settings for streaming or for recording, you hit that and it'll do a wizard that looks at what your computer is, and then it goes to YouTube or Twitter, and it does these little 11 second, 9 second, 8 second videos, you know, that matches everything up, and it suggests a video for you, and they suggest that you put your videos on unlisted so that it doesn't go live while they do this. So that's what I did, except for this one, I had to change it afterwards. But all they do is they go in and they run a test, and the test looks kind of like this. And I'll let you guys see this, but it's just a little 10-minute test with a little white background. And with this test, they determine what's the best settings for you. And I like that, because I'm not really all that great with FPS right now. And I'm working at it, but it's big help. It helps me when it comes to knowing my computer and what I need to have the settings set up for. So now with that, I'm pretty much setting up my video now to show you some of the things I had to go through to do the setups. And like I said, I need to go into my Movie Maker, and I need to set the video footage up. When it comes to Audacity, I do like the audio here, but I'm going to determine if I still need to use Audacity too, because like with the background audio, I have noticed in these videos it picks up a lot of the background audios, and I've got my settings on Audacity to where it doesn't do that. If I can do that with OBS the same way I did with Audacity, then I won't have to use Audacity anymore, but I may have to continue to do it if it doesn't do it, because like right now in this video, you're probably hearing some of the background sounds, and that's because I'm working out of the laundry room, and the kitchen is right next door with a TV, So you're probably hearing some of that. And I'll check all that out too and see if I can change the settings on that. But I wanted to update you on this. And then now I'm going to go in, I'm going to edit some of the audio and video, because I got like 45 clips of, even more actually, of just working with this. So I just want to thin it out and make a good couple good videos on audio, and I will post that as I go. But yeah, so far I'm okay with OBS, and if things go good with this, I may give up XSplitter altogether, because in my videos I'll show you what it does. It's just ridiculous. I'm having a lot of hassle with it.
And